Good evening. It's a sincere privilege to be here tonight with Marty, his family, and Coach Mike Gilligan as we pay tribute to and honor a true legend of the gut. During his 4 years as a Catamount and on this ice with many of you in attendance, he dazzled sold-out crowds as he rewrote record books while leading UVM to unprecedented on-ice success. Most career points, assists, game-winning goals, and shorthanded goals are but a few of his records which still stand today. His skill and style created a buzz and excitement in Burlington and all across the state for this great sport and made UVM hockey games the place to be. That is, if you could get a ticket. His contributions to the hockey program and university were immense, and we are most grateful and fortunate that he accepted Coach Gilligan's offer to leave his home province of Quebec and become a Catamount. Some 20 years later, he would be named a recipient of the UVM Distinguished Alumni Award. After all that he accomplished here, he realized even more success in the National Hockey League, where he led Tampa Bay to the Stanley Cup and piled up a long list of individual awards and appearances in NHL All-Star Games. A future Hockey Hall of Fame member, we are proud that Catamount Country played an important role in his growth and development as an athlete, as a student, and as a person. He has been a great ambassador for UVM and as a role model for our youth. Marty has conducted his life with tremendous passion, dignity, and grace. He has been all that we hope for in our heroes, overcoming obstacles to achieve greatness, yet never losing sight of who he is, where he came from, and those who helped him along the way. His humility and positive spirit have separated him from the crowd and have enabled him to impact so many people, both in and outside of hockey. In recognition of all that he has accomplished and for the manner in which he has represented the values of our athletic program and university, it is my great pleasure to announce that tonight, for the first time in our history, the university will be retiring a men's hockey jersey. Number 8 now belongs exclusively to Martin Saint-Louis. Congratulations, Marty.
Thank you, Bob. And now to make sure that no UVM men's hockey player will ever wear number 8 again, it's time to make good on that promise. At this time, please welcome the Catamounts' current and final number 8, senior forward Jonathan Turk, accompanied by senior captain Evan Patton. Turk will make a special presentation to Marty. So now, fans, a slight adjustment to your game program. Jonathan Turk, from this point on, will wear number 88. And number 8 officially belongs to one man. Without further ado, it's my pleasure to introduce NCAA, NHL, Olympic, and most importantly, Vermont legend, number 8, Mr. Marty St. Louis.
Thank you. Good evening. Thank you. I am flattered and humbled by this opportunity of by this outpouring of support. I would like to thank Coach Schnedden and Coach Gaudette and their staff, as well as both of these teams, for taking the time from the game tonight to be part of this celebration. UVM's hockey program has had some tremendous athletes come through, and I couldn't be more proud to have been a Catamount. I would like to thank President Sullivan, Athletic Director Bob Korn, Assistant AD Jeff Schulman for making this night possible. It is amazing for me to be standing here again at the GUT. I have so many great memories from my time at UVM. And so many of them were here on the ice. I think back of when I was on the bench and the teammates and coaches I had here. I learned so much, both as a person and a player. Coach Gilligan, you are my head coach. He taught me some valuable life lessons. I saw from him the importance of being a good human and to treat everyone with respect. He was one of my biggest supporters. When I struggled throughout my career, I could always count on him to send me a text and always say, keep your head up, keep pushing. It'll come back around. Thanks, Coach. Roger Grillo was one of my assistant coaches. What started as coaching me here didn't end until the day I retired. I'm sorry, Raj. Aside from coaches, they were coaching me at the time. Roger was always the most valued and influential voice on my hockey career. It was he who I would call when I was in a slump, but also when I was doing well. He would have watched my game and knew the fine balance of telling me when he saw something I needed to work on. But he also knew when I was down on myself and needed to be pumped up. Through the years, we have developed a very strong friendship. And now that I am retired and coaching my boys, I go to him all the time for guidance on how to coach, since Roger's with the U.S. Hockey Development Program. Little did he know, his coaching wasn't over for me after my 4 years, you know. Only another 20 years after that, so thanks, Raj. I also would like to thank my other assistant coach, Joe Gervais, and also former athletic director, Rick Farnham, helping me navigate through my college career and always being positive influence on my life. Thanks, guys. I am honored to have so many of my former teammates here tonight. It means so much to me that you all took the time out to be here. The reality is I wouldn't be here tonight without them. I have some truly amazing teammates, many of whom became some of my closest friends to this day. It is here that I really learned how important it is to have a tight, close, cohesive group of teammates. That proved to be something that helped me in the pros to be a better leader and a team player. Thanks, guys. Although he isn't here tonight, he would be remiss for me not to give a huge thank you to one of my oldest friends, Eric Perrin. We were the dynamic duo, the French connection. It was with him that I saw how important chemistry with a line mate can be. Throughout my career, I always try to find that same kind of chemistry. I would not be here tonight if it wasn't for Eric. I am honored that I am the first to have their jersey retired, but I do hope that someday his jersey's right up there next to mine. It was also here at UVM, through Coach Gilligan, that I met my agent, Lewis Gross. I am grateful that he was with me from the get-go. What started as a player-agent relationship, it became a true friendship. Thanks, Lewis, for your guidance and your friendship. Really appreciate it. It was also here that I met my wife, Heather. Who knew that our college romance would turn into a marriage and three kids? I couldn't be more blessed and so happy to have her and our three boys, Ryan, Lucas, and Mason. I thank them all for all their love and understanding throughout the years. My dad and sister are here as well tonight, and I thank them for the support they always provide me. Also, to all my other family and friends here tonight, I thank you all. I really mean it. You guys have always been there for me. Good, bads, good and bad times. And lastly, there is one person who is not here tonight. Although she's here in spirit, and she sat right there in that section 25 for all the games. She didn't miss the game. I wish she was really here because she loved Vermont and loved coming to all my games. She would have been so proud. I know she is smiling down on all of us. Thank you, Mom. Thank you for all being here tonight. Vermont fans are some of the best I've ever known. From the moment I stepped on the ice in 1993, I felt the fans behind me all the way. The energy the fan brings to the gut, it always gave me another gear. And for that, I am thankful. Enjoy the game. Go Cats, go.
Fans, at this time, please direct your attention to center ice as we raise Marty's number 8 to its permanent place in the Gutterson rafters, never to be worn again in the history of Catamount men's hockey.